The interest rate hike by the Federal Reserve is an effort to slow inflation. Inflation is happening because the economy is sped up. There is too much demand and not enough supply. So their effort is to increase the cost of short-term lending, your credit cards, your car loans, personal loans. And by increasing that, people will start spending a little bit less using their own cash. That will slow down the demand and open up the supply. The Federal Reserve is not increasing mortgage rates. They're increasing the money that banks are borrowing. They're increasing the rate that they charge banks. And that filters through all the different types of lending products that banks use, which includes credit cards, car loans, personal loans, and of course, mortgages. Banks, for the most part, don't lend out their own money. They borrow the money from the Federal Reserve. So when the rate increase goes into effect, it of course means that the bank has to pass that on to the general public through these different lending products that they have. For the most part, the effect that it's going to have on home values is not going to be as drastic as people think. There's a difference now between the housing crash. Some people are comparing it to the housing crash of 2008. It's actually very different. The housing crash of 2008 and the steep decline in values at that point in time were actually caused by the housing market itself, by the lending institutions that since have been regulated. A lot of things have changed. The way that borrowers are qualified to secure a mortgage has changed. And there has been a lot of protection built into the way that home buyers go through the lending process in order to own a home. So it's a little bit different now. What's happening is the Federal Reserve is having to slow inflation on the general economy. So it's a little bit different. The mortgage rates are going to go up, probably one or two more adjustments. But as far as the monthly payment goes, it could be a several hundred dollars change in your payment. It's just something you need to sit down and budget for. Prices on homes will pull back a little bit, but it's not going to cause a housing crash. Something that will happen is the buyer pool will start to shift around. So people that were qualifying for a little bit more may rethink their budget, decrease the amount that they want to spend every month, and that will move them into a different bracket as far as the homes that they're looking at. That will help sort of stagger the pools of buyers that are looking at different homes and open up the inventory a little bit. But with regard to values to homes in the city, if anything, they seem to be holding, if not continuing to increase. So inventory will open up, but I don't see a decline in value happening. Really, the housing market, when you talk about it, there are some areas that naturally move a little bit quicker. For example, the city tends to be a little more transient just because you have professionals that are moving into the city, establishing a career, and then starting a family and moving to the suburbs. The suburbs seem to be a more stable market, where when values come up, they actually tend to be more stable than they are in the city. And that's simply because the city is a transient environment. People move into the city for a period of time and then they move back out to the suburbs or in some cases to another state. So for the most part, both markets have continued to stay strong and will continue to stay strong. With the change in the interest rates the Federal Reserve is implementing, it's going to slow the economy, as I mentioned, by decreasing the demand. And so something you really want to focus on is trying to pay cash for anything that you can. Try to minimize your credit card usage, or in some cases, if you do need to regularly use a credit card, you'll want to make sure that you shop around a little bit and find a credit card that works for you with regard to the interest rates. So sometimes you can talk to different lenders, find out what cards they offer, find something that suits your life a little bit better. Maybe there's a point system that they have, or you can find something that has a little bit lower of an interest rate. In some cases, you can even still find 0% on a credit card. Put all of your other cards on that and save yourself some interest there. You know, for the short term, that's what you're going to see. Higher credit card interest rates, car loans, same thing. The rates are going to go up a little bit. It's going to make car buying slow down just a little bit, but it will also open up the supply of cars, because that's also been a very difficult market. Purchasing a car has been difficult. The demand has been up, the cost has been up, and the supply has been down. So by raising the rates again, it's going to be one of those categories that is going to open up as far as the inventory goes and make more product available for folks. And again, it's something where you just want to make sure you're aware of your budget. In these times, especially since it's not something that has been out there in the past couple of years, everything has been a little bit lower with regard to the rates that we're charged on things. Sit down with your family, sit down with your significant other, or even just with yourself. Talk to a professional that's a credit counselor. Evaluate your budget and put something together that makes sure that you are operating in a space that's going to keep everything moving and keep everything safe for yourself. You know, a time like this is just part of life. It's a cycle. It's a cycle that we've been through before. It's nothing new. They're not punishing the public. They're actually making an effort to slow the economy and make it so that when you go to the grocery store, food's a little more affordable. Gasoline is a little more affordable. The daily things that you need are all more a little bit affordable. So overall, this is a move to bring things back to a better place. So we just got to work together, be mindful of your budget, decide where it is that you want to spend your money, and just work your way through it. Stick together with your family, work your way through it. Everything will be fine. There is nothing to panic about.